As we've gathered for worship, the Christ candle has been lit, and we are reminded that Christ is the light of the world. We're going to start this morning with sharing some good news. Amy left me a whole bunch of announcements, so I'm going to start there. And as you're listening to the announcements, think about the blessings you had this week. So first, the Wesley House wishes to thank Linden Park for participating and raising funds for Wesley's case for kids this year. Our group raised $630, which goes directly to funding our children and youth programming. Overall, Case for Kids raised $94,500. Yeah. Wesley House couldn't do it without supporters like the public and our group here at Linden Park Community Church. So upcoming events at Wesley include a knapsack drive, which ends on the 24th, which is this coming Wednesday. They're hoping to pack 350 backpacks for kids and youth leading back to school this fall. And if you need more information, you can go to the wesley.ca website and get all of the information there. I believe the information may be already posted on the bulletin board. Thank you. Wesley's annual gold tournament is taking place September 12th at Century Pines. So all you interested golfers out there can sign up on their website. And last but not least, the office likes to thank everyone who donated drinking boxes and helped set up and tear down the Friday Fun Kids Arts and Crafts. This last Friday was the last day for the summer due to the bees. Yeah. It was an amazing experience, which reached out to approximately 12 families in the neighborhood. Any leftover drinking boxes will be carried into the next upcoming family outreach. Stay tuned. So Amy must have something in her back pocket.
Thank you to Amy.
Yeah, she did a really, really good job. And Amy and her family are taking a much deserved time away camping, so I'm hoping they're not too wet this morning. And God bless them as they recreate. They spend time in the beauty of creation. Now, are there any other blessings or celebrations that you'd like to share? Sharon.
She'll be 95 in October.
Oh, wow. So a visit with Dorothy. She's doing well in her new long-term care facility. And will be turning 95 in October. So that's wonderful.
Last week, Jackie announced that it was my birthday this past week. Today, I get to tell you that Jackie's birthday is coming up this week. I can't say what the number is, but I'm sure she would be glad to tell you.
You can't see what I'm seeing, but the eyes are rolling.
21.
21. Again.
Over again and again.
And again. Yeah. So we should sing. You sing happy birthday? Oh, another birthday? Oh, right. I'll catch that in a minute then. We'll sing happy birthday first.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Jackie. Happy birthday to you.
I hope you have a great day. Blessings. Yes, and there's a reminder that fun scripts are due this week. By Thursday and Sunday.
Next Sunday.
Next Sunday. Okay. There you go. You got your orders done. That's fine. Anything else that I should be aware of? No more blessings? Okay. That's wonderful. The only blessing I can share is that the landlord arrived at our place Sunday afternoon last week, and finally, we have no more alarms going off in the middle of the night. Well, a couple of them weren't working right, and they should have been working until 2028. So he took them down, and we got brand new ones, and he explained the whole system to me, which was really nice. But it's a blessing to know that that thing's not going to go off at 5 o'clock in the morning just because. So that, and again, more family time. Yes.
And the boy that was sitting beside me here when I come back up
here. Yes.
Had open heart surgery.
Okay.
It's a month ago now. And he is doing well.
He's doing well.
I talk to him every day, so
yeah.
I know how he's progressing.
Okay. So blessings for healing after open heart surgery. Yeah. Crazy for sure. Well, I want to just have a little bit. Oh, we got one more at the back.
Lots of thanks to people who were asking, but also who donated for the Sox garage sale. We raised $438.80 yesterday. So thanks to all.
Oh, wow. Yay. For the Sox garage sale. Wonderful. Does Landon want to come up to the front? Or maybe not.
He's coming. Okay. I'm bringing Joy with me. So today we're going to be talking about remembering. You don't have to run. That's okay. So a number of people have had family visits and have had time away on special trips. Oh. Is it something I said? Landon, when you do something special, what do you do to remember that? Or do you never do anything special? Hey, Mom. He's laughing. So what would you do? You just remember. You don't do anything special to remember? No? Aw. So, do you do anything special, say, for your birthday? Do you have cake? Okay. And candles? Yeah?
It wouldn't be a birthday cake if it didn't have candles.
Isn't that the truth? It would just be cake. So, if you put candles in a peach pie, Is that then a birthday pie? Maybe. And do you do anything special like Christmas to remember? Just one thing.
I don't remember anything like Christmas except for unwrapping presents.
Unwrapping presents. Okay.
And I actually got some.
And you actually got some. Wow.
I got a lot of stuff in my stocking.
Got a lot of stuff in the stocking. And presents. But you remember, don't you? Yeah. Well, this is Joy.
I even got slime in my stocking. Mm-hmm.
Okay, I'm not sure.
No, there's an egg and I opened it.
Oh, the egg with the slime in it.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
But I lost it.
You lost it. Oh, I'm so sorry. Well, I'm going to... Well, I'm going to show you Joy right now. And Joy reminds me that Jesus is the Good Shepherd. It's also a remembrance for me of my very first learning circle on my way to becoming a pastor. Yeah. It's really soft.
No, it's so soft.
It's so soft. And it came with me in every one of my learning circles. And each circle that Joy was there, I was reminded about the Good Shepherd. And sometimes we need reminders, don't we? Yeah. Can you pray with me? And everyone can join in. Let's pray together. Dear God, we thank you for times of remembering, and especially your love. Amen. Thank you. And if anybody is wondering, Joy is very soft, and he got squished to the bottom of the suitcase more than once. Let's open our time of worship by singing the first verse of our hymn of the day, number 559. I hope that's the right one. And if you'd like to stand, you're more than welcome to do so. Come, O fount of every blessing. Can you give me a bit more of an introduction? Maybe the last line? Oh, good. Thank you. Marilla to come forward and share the scripture for this morning. And I'm going to apologize. I sent her a message last night in apology. Some of the names in here are a little tricky, so just skim over them as best you can.
First Samuel chapter 7, verses 1 to 12. So the men of Kiriath-Jearim came and took up the ark of the Lord. They brought it to Abinadab's house on the hill and consecrated Eleazar his son to guard the ark of the Lord. The ark remained at Kiriath-Jearim a long time, 20 years in all. Then all the people of Israel turned back to the Lord. So Samuel said to all the Israelites, "If you are returning to the Lord with all your hearts, then rid yourselves of the foreign gods and the Asherah, and commit yourself to the Lord and serve him only, and he will deliver you out of the hand of the Philistines." So the Israelites put away their Baals and Asherah and served the Lord only. Then Samuel said, "Assemble all Israel at Mizpah, and I will intercede with the Lord for you." When they had assembled at Mizpah, they drew water and poured it out before the Lord. On that day they fasted, and there they confessed, "We have sinned against the Lord." Now Samuel was serving as leader of Israel at Mizpah. When the Philistines heard that Israel had assembled at Mizpah, the rulers of the Philistines came up to attack them. When the Israelites heard of it, they were afraid because of the Philistines. They said to Samuel, "Do not stop crying out to the Lord our God for us, that he may rescue us from the hand of the Philistines." Then Samuel took a suckling lamb and sacrificed it as a whole burnt offering of the Lord. He cried out to the Lord on Israel's behalf, and the Lord answered him. While Samuel was sacrificing the burnt offering, the Philistine drew near to engage Israel in battle. But that day the Lord thundered with loud thunder against the Philistines and threw them into such a panic that they were routed before the Israelites. The men of Israel rushed out of Mizpah and pursued the Philistines, slaughtering them along the way to a point below Beth Kar. Then Samuel took a stone and set it up between Mizpah and Shen. His name is Ebenezer, saying that thus for the Lord had helped us. The word of the Lord.
May the scriptures heard today bring a blessing and an understanding. And I think actually this time we will sing that second verse. We'll remain seated by hymn 559 in the second verse. Here I pause. Pray with me. Holy and living God, as we've gathered today and we've heard the Holy Scriptures, may the words of my mouth and the meditations of all of our hearts be acceptable to you, O God, our strength and our Redeemer. Amen. So what I didn't realize when I chose this hymn was that the United Church hymnal have changed the words. As the key phrase here was from where Marla just read, where, Samuel took a stone and set it up between Mizpah and Jeshana and named it Ebenezer. And in that hymn of old, it goes, "Here I raise my Ebenezer." It's that phrase that really stuck in my mind. And over the years, I've looked at it from different angles and talked with different ministers and pastors about it. I'm thinking, Ebenezer, what is that? What does it mean? And for some people, it's a standard. Lift high the cross. A standard is a flag. For other people, it's a cairn where you place all the stones, and that's exactly what they did. They placed stones in a spot, and it was called the Ebenezer, or an Ebenezer. Did you know that? Yeah. In our Canadian Indigenous traditions, we think of Inukshuk as an Ebenezer. And it's often a sign to go this way or that way. Or it's a monument to remember. Think of the cairns that we see, especially at war memorials or veterans memorials, where it's this triangle kind of thing often. You've seen those, right? Yeah. It's about remembering. And what happened here is that the Israelites had come back to God. And in hearing that, the Philistines, their leadership heard that the Hebrew people had all come back to God. And they said, well, we don't want that. So they were planning an attack once again. But the Lord prevailed with a thundering voice from the heavens and confused them, and they went away. Now, that's kind of a shortened version of what Marla read for us, but it was the Lord that provided because of their prayers and because of Samuel's strength and leadership. They asked him, continue to pray. And he did. Praying continuously, unceasingly praying. But I think about remembering, and for the last couple of weeks, we've been talking about blessings in our lives, what blessings we've had, what blessings we give thanks for. And this is another way for a blessing to remember. I don't know, how many of you are on Facebook? There's quite a few actually. And every day, if you have any, it'll come up and say, this is what happened back in whatever, 7 years ago, 8 years ago, 10 years ago, depending on how long you've been there. And I look at that each morning. And I see pictures of family, places I've been, the harvest, a dinner table, because I often take pictures of food. Go figure. But I remember. Have you ever been to a beach and there's a certain smell? Now, I'm not talking about the fishy smell that you can sometimes get at Port Dover, because sometimes it used to smell pretty fishy. But there's a certain smell, and when you smell that, you remember. Even the icky, fishy smell reminded me of years ago when my dad took my brother and I to Port Dover for Canada Day. Must have smelled then too. But it brings back the memories. When we see certain things, I was in Port Stanley not too long ago. I hadn't been back in years, hadn't been to the beach in years. There's a community welcome information center sitting where my house used to be. My house was demolished and a road put through, anyway. But it brought back the memories, being at the beach, being with family. And in fact, one of the beaches I was at this summer, probably Southampton, maybe, or Point Clark, I picked up a tiny shell that had been weathered by the water and the waves, and a flat stone that my granddaughter gave me, and they're actually sitting in a little dish on the kitchen table. And they remind me of that time. A few weeks ago, maybe even last week, I had my big bag, my beach bag, and in the bottom of that was a piece of driftwood that I had picked up a number of years ago in Southampton, reminding me of time with family and time at the beach. They're simple items, but bring back powerful memories. And as a musician, music does that, right? A favorite song, a favorite hymn, reminds me of a specific occasion. Do you get that way sometimes, Sylvia? Yeah. Yeah. Anybody else get that way with songs? Because they go deep in our hearts. And our hymns do the same thing, don't they? They go deep in our hearts and they remind us of someone or a time, or they basically remind us of Scripture and the love of God. In a sense, a type of Ebenezer, if you will. They did this act with the stones to praise God and to give thanks. To praise God and give thanks. And I think we can give thanks and praise God in the same time, can't we? Praise God and give thanks. But there's other times in our scriptures where we are to remember famous words in Deuteronomy chapter 6, verse 4. Hear, O Israel, the Lord is our God, the Lord alone. It's known as the Shema. And in Hebrew or Jewish tradition, it said first thing in the morning, Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is one. And then it said at bedtime, The Lord our God is one. As a remembering. And some homes would have that printed on the doorpost or above the door. So when you enter, you see it. In some Jewish traditions, they still wear the little box on their head. And in that box are those words. And it's a reminder, an Ebenezer, if you would. And you're to keep it with you at all times. Now, if you remember, when Jesus was asked, Teacher, what is the greatest commandment? He knew the first one. The Lord your God is one Lord. Hear, O Israel. Israel being the people of God, not the place, but the people. The Lord is our God. The Lord is one, one and only God. So let's think for a minute. Let's take it away from, say, the Old Testament, the Hebrew Scriptures, and into the good news of the Gospels. Are we ever told to remember anything? You're going, I don't remember what you're talking about. Do you remember? I remember the two other people on the cross with Jesus. And the one said, Jesus, remember me when I come into your kingdom. And in fact, it's in our hymn book, right? Jesus, remember me when I come into your kingdom. Jesus, remember me when I come into your kingdom. So somebody wanted to be remembered. He recognized Jesus for who he was. He's going to God's kingdom, and was going to be remembered. But what else is there? There's a couple of things in our scriptures that tell us. And Jesus said, yeah, Karen. Do this what? In remembrance of me. And where do we find that? In our communion service. The Last Supper. Right? As you share the cup and the bread. Bread broken. Cup, the living life of Christ. Christ told us, do this in remembrance of me. When I wear a cross, whether it's the big one I have here, the little one underneath, it reminds me of the risen Lord. It reminds me of the love that Jesus has for not only myself, but for everyone around us and me. When we see the Christ candle lit, it reminds us of the light of Christ. An Ebenezer, maybe. Are there other things that remind us? Our Holy Scriptures. Now, I wouldn't necessarily do this. I don't hold a Bible in my hand when I preach. I'd probably end up breaking it somehow, but I raise my Ebenezer, my Bible. The living Word of God. There was one preacher that used to say and to teach, you know, the Bible in one hand and the newspaper in the other. I think that might have been Wesley. So you preach relevance today, but you preach through the words of God. So what does all of this mean for us today? This whole idea that the people of Israel returned to God, and the Israelites, or the Philistines, were coming after them again to defeat them. Samuel prayed, the Lord thundered, they went away. That's the short answer, right? How do we take that scripture and place it into our world today, into our own homes today? Somebody mentioned to me years ago that the harder you try to be good, the harder the devil's going to work to pull you back. The easiest example in my own life is my food. The harder I try to eat the good stuff, the more the not so good stuff for me pulls at me, right? So what do? I need to pray more. I need to affirm my convictions for my health, for my husband, for all of you. That's kind of a trite little way to look at it, but there are times when the more good we do, it feels like we're moving backwards. Have you ever been in that position? And you're waiting for the other foot to fall, the other shoe to drop? Because you know things can't keep going this good forever. That's kind of a fatalistic approach to things, and that's not God's way of approaching things, is it? But it's human nature. So we're being drawn back. Think Star Wars. We're going back to the dark side as opposed to Master Yoda talking about the Force and the good in us all. What is your Ebenezer? What is the one thing in your life that you know you can turn to in any given moment and find strength and remembering your faith? For me, it's those hymns. It's the music. Earlier today, before many of you came in, I sat down and played the piano, played some hymns that calms my spirit, that helps me to center on purpose and focus on God. What do you do? What Ebenezer is there in your home or in your life that can draw you back to God when you're being pulled away from God? And being pulled away from God, you know what that's called? That's called sin. Anything that pulls us away from God, that takes away our connection with the divine. We all need God's love. We all need to say, look, God, I messed up. I'm sorry. We all need to go to the people we've hurt and say, look, I did not mean to say that. I did not mean to give you a look. Because sometimes a look can make people go, what's wrong with her? No? You say sorry and you pray. And we know that when we pray, God forgives. But we need that remembrance, don't we? We need to remember who we are as children of God. And come to God I find it wonderful to be in this building today worshiping with you, returning to God yet once again. Each week we come. We are not forsaking. We are not forsaking the assembly of believers. That's what Paul would say. Do not neglect the assembly of our neighbors and our fellow believers. We need to come together as one body, one church, one faith, one baptism. We are not alone. We live where? In God's world. Thanks be to God. Raise your Ebenezer high, even if it's only in your mind. And may God bless you always. Amen. Amen. Thank you, Sylvia. That was beautiful, wasn't it? At this time, let's join our hearts together in prayer. Holy God, holy wisdom, divine love, help us to remember the blessings in our lives. Help us to grow in strength and in love through your divine power and through the words of Holy Scripture. We pray with those who are celebrating today with joyful hearts, congratulations, with love. And we pray with those who are praying for others who need healing, for family members who are facing diverse conditions that overwhelm them. We pray for those who have no home, little food, no family to turn to, no hope. May God's loving arms surround them and give them comfort as we find comfort. We pray for the world in turmoil and in destruction, from the earth groaning to gunfire and famine. We pray for the leaders of the world. Grant them wisdom. Grant them courage to do what is right for all. We pray for those who are on holiday, for those who are or will be camping, for safety on those roads. We pray for safety and awareness for all of those who take care of us, for the police services, the fire crews, the paramedics. We pray for the doctors, the nurses, and those with healing hands. We are so thankful, God, that we live in this time and in this place where there are blessings all around us. Help us to open our eyes and see what's in front of us. Forgive us when we close off our eyes and our hearts to what is needed. Help us to ask for forgiveness, knowing that you will always forgive. And for the things that we should or could have done, help us, oh God, to see those, to find those opportunities where we can help and love one another. We pray for each family represented here and those who are listening online. And we lift all up to the light and the love of God, Creator, Sustainer, and Redeemer. May all of our blessings continue to flow as we have been blessed. So may we be blessed. All this in Jesus' name we pray, and we pray the words that Jesus taught his disciples to say: Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen and amen. I'm just going to mention here really quickly, Ken says, good morning, everyone. Love you all, Bonnie and Ken Medino. And another Bonnie is watching, a friend of mine from Stittsville. So hi, Bonnie. And for all of you who will be watching later, hello and God's blessing. And at this time, we'll have the offering brought forward. I don't know whether one of the youngsters is going to do that. Ah, there we go. Please rise. We ask, oh God, that these gifts that are given freely from our abundance and from our tithes, that they be blessed to the use of the people of the world and in our community. Amen. And then when he comes back, we'll sing our last verse of our hymn. So while he's coming up, just a reminder, if any of you are interested in joining the choir, we'll be starting up in September.
Oh, I'm excited about that. A few other things are going to be starting up again and happening. Exciting. We'll have a rally Sunday. And what else are we going to do?
So what's this called?
That's the 5 o'clock.
So you think this is a normal 5 o'clock?
We think it's a normal 5 o'clock, yeah.
Well, what if I told you it's a 5 of diamonds? Oh. Let me just put it in the back.
He's going to tell me it wasn't the 5 o'clock, it was the 5 of diamonds. See, just like that. Thank you, Mr. Sherry. God bless you, dear.
The 5 of diamonds, huh? Yes, Karen.
As you were mentioning, things are starting up. And if anyone has any nieces, nephews, grandchildren, and you want to put them in scouting, bring them on over. We will have a date firm next week.
Okay.
When we're going to have a get-together. But the more the merrier. We've done a lot of exciting things all year. The Beavers actually just went down to the pier this week and saw the whole pier on the trolley. It was really fun. And Stuart's been telling me everything about Medved, so bring your kids out.
So Cubs and Scouting will be starting up, and there'll be a time and day mentioned where you can come for information and just see what's going on. That's awesome. See, lots of exciting things happening. And also the Sunday, next week? No, the week after, Labor Day weekend, we'll be doing a blessing of the backpack. So if the boys would like to bring a backpack or something, we'll bless and send them off to school once again.
Yay.
Oh, okay. Wonderful. So let's stand once again and sing the last verse of Come, O Fount of Every Blessing. If you could give us that last line again, please.
Oh, to grace, how great a debtor, daily I am drawn anew. Let the grace now, like a fetter, bind my wandering heart to you. Prone to wander, I can feel it, wander from the love of home. Here's my heart, oh, take and seal it, seal it for your very throne.
Come, blessings. Come, all you people, to the love of God. That's what we've done today, and we'll continue to do so. May you find your Ebenezer, that one rock, that stone, that monument that speaks to you, not only today, but every day. And may you go with God's blessing, God's love, Brother Jesus to walk beside you, and the Holy Spirit to lift you up and guide you. In Jesus' name, amen. And we sing. No, just start.
Lord, love me.
Lonely, you are in dream.
God bless. Have a good week, everyone.